Hi, in this video we will learn the basics of Solstice to get you up to speed quickly. We will look at how to sign up to Solstice, how to create your first survey, and how to then deploy that survey to your app. Let's get started. You can access Solstice, the portal side, on the URL solstice.world. On this page, to sign up to the system, you can just click sign up here on the top right. Now we need to fill in a few fields. Name, username, password, email address, and ideally also your employer. Please confirm that you are at least of 13 years of age. You can also sign up using Google, Facebook, or Windows Live. Sign up is free and using the system is free as well. This brings you into the system where we see a number of new tabs. In this example, I want to create a survey around tracking community level ODF, that is open defecation free communities. In Solstice, we can create any kind of surveys we want, including all the questions that we decide belong to that survey. So, let's go to the Surveys tab. On the Surveys tab, we can see a list of all the surveys that are visible to us. I'm a fresh user, so I don't see anything yet. I want to create a new survey, and this brings me to the survey design screen, where I have a mouse-driven interface where I can add as many questions as I like. So let's name our survey. And then we can start adding questions. To add a question, I can click the Add button and then select New Question. The first question I want to add is whether or not the community has been declared ODF. So I'll choose a drop-down question type to give my users the option to choose yes or no. I'll type in the question text. I'll give choices. Either yes, no, and for don't know, I can choose the system version of the don't know option here. I'll also make this question required by ticking the requires answer box. Okay, so now I see my question as it has come to the survey. Next, let's add a new one around which date the community was declared ODF. So again, I select new question. This time I select a date question type, type in the question text, use the standard date format year, month, and date, also make this required. And now I also want to know which community does this survey relate to. There's a couple of ways I could do this. I could start adding questions for the name of the community, the location, and geo-coordinates, and so on. But in Solstice, we recommend using sites. Sites allow you to map geographical entities, such as communities, schools, hospitals, water points, and so on, and do it only once. And then you can link your survey questions to those sites over and over again, so you don't need to keep tracking the same basic information and asking it from enumerators over and over again. So that's the option I'll choose here. I'll add a new question. It will be the site type question. I'll make sure to choose the community site type. And I'll make this required as well. Now I have my three survey questions and I'm ready to deploy. Quickly going through some of the other tabs. If I wanted to translate this survey to other languages, I can use the Translate tab to do so myself. If I want to see what the survey will look like on my device, I can use the Preview tab. On the Settings tab, I can set permissions for the survey, that is, who gets to edit the survey design, who gets to deploy it to enumerators, and who can just view the survey design. I'm interested in the Deploy tab, where I get to activate the survey to one or more enumerators so that it appears in their app. So I will deploy to specific enumerators. It gives me an option to deploy to an entire organization, which is very useful for a larger data collection enterprise. But this time I'm deploying it just to myself. This deployment screen, I will give my deployment a title. I'll make sure it's active. I will add an enumerator. That'll be me. This can be as many users as you need, as many branches of organizations. And then I want to also have my manager check this information as it comes through. So I will add an approval chain, put my manager as the approver. And before the data that gets submitted from the field becomes finalized, it has to go through this approval chain. Then I will save the deployment. That's it. I can see that my deployment is now active, and I will start seeing this survey on my app. If I go to my app, either at app.solstice.world or in the Android app or iOS app, and I synchronize, making sure that the survey information is downloaded from the cloud, I will now be able to see the survey. I can start it from either the homepage Start a Survey button or from Add Start a Survey. And I see it here at the top. So now we've seen how to sign up to Solstice, how to start designing your survey, how to deploy it so that it appears on your app.